Today we are going to create a digital art by merging 4 images in the free Snapseed app. After importing this image to Snapseed, first I need to separate background from the foreground to make it easier to add a new image as a background. For that, I need to try making the foreground completely black and the background white. First, I'm going to apply black and white filter and select blue in the color options. This makes the warm colors more dark, in this case the foreground, also adding contrast. With curves, I'm going to add high contrast. Trying here to make the foreground completely black and the background white. There are still white spots remaining in the foreground. To make them black, with curves, dragging the top right point completely down to make the image black. Then with masking, with the effect disabled and brush value at 100, brushing on the white spots to get the foreground completely black. For the final look which I intend, the foreground needs to be more dark. So here, going back to the original step, then opening curves, I'm gonna darken the image. Also adding some reds and yellows for the evening colors. Going to the masking screen. I'm gonna get back the brightness on the main subject. I'm not worried about the background here as that part will be excluded anyway, which you will know later. Also bringing some brightness back here where there will be some evening light falling there. I'm gonna save this and also remove this effect by deleting it. Coming back to the last step where the image is completely black and white. Using the double exposure tool, I will add the last saved image and choose the blend mode add, which basically removes the added image on the white areas. Again with double exposure, I'm gonna add the image of a red sky. Choose darken mode, which makes the added image less intensive in the darker areas but completely visible on the white parts from the previous effect. Dragging and placing it to make only the sky part visible in the background. With masking, removing some remnants of the sky image in the foreground. Now to add more light at the edge, I'm going to use curves, increasing brightness, also adding greens and reds, which combined add some yellows to the image. With masking, applying the effect around the right horizon here. Now adding image of the clouds using double exposure. The original was a color one, I turned it into a black and white, applied contrast and had saved it. After adding, placing it so that the clouds are just above the main subject. Taking time here to get it as intended. Setting the opacity to 100. with masking, removing the parts other than the clouds. Carefully working on the edges to make it look a bit more natural. I'm gonna add a couple of selective filters to make the clouds more darker. Going to masking screen, making sure that the darkening effect did not apply on the foreground. Next, adding the image of the Milky Way. Placing it more towards the top, setting the opacity to 100, with masking, with the effect hidden, revealing the night sky where we placed it. Working a little more to get the placement and the masking right. Applying the vintage filter with preset 12. Decreasing the V-net strength just a little. Going to the masking screen, trying here to make only the top parts a bit dark. I'm gonna make the clouds more darker using selective filters. Now to the brush tool for some dodging. With the dodge and burn value set at +5, brushing on the subject to make him a little more brighter to get some pop there. Also a bit on the rocks too. Going to the tune image menu now, adding more brightness to the highlights. Also making image more warm by increasing warmth. With masking, removing the warmth effect in the night sky. the changes made after each effect. And the final result. Thanks for watching.